This week on Hashtag Taiwan, dating. Now guys, like most other things, I tend to fail miserably at, and I'm saying like crash and burn fail.
Oh, Leslie.
I like to leave it to people who know exactly what they're doing. Like this guy, his name is Potter, and I got a video for you.
总统就是，你知道，现场很多人都喜欢你，有一些甚至会把你当成偶像。但是我没有，我没有把你当成偶像，我把你当成我结婚对象。
我要忍，要准备把他架走了。总统，
我觉得你如果再继续跟我相处一阵子的话，你可能会变坏人。你知道为什么吗？因为我想把你宠坏。请问你在网络上骗的？没有没有。这个是你自己想的吗？没有，我自己想的。啊，你要昭告天下，这个人太危险了。He's
good, isn't he?
That guy's hilarious.
He's very funny.
Pretty good.
Yeah,
I love that.
His name is Potter King, and he's a very popular YouTuber here in Taiwan. His videos focus on dating advice, and you gotta admit, he's pretty good. He gets a rise out of President Tsai, who I usually see as a very stoic and reserved kind of person. Now, leading up to the election, President Tsai has been making a lot of social media videos with popular internet celebrities here in Taiwan. Potter King is one of these guys. Now, Potter King is also very, very popular in China, and as you might imagine, authorities there were not very happy about a famous internet figure appearing in a video with the president of Taiwan. Now, usually on Hashtag Taiwan, I like to give you the abridged version of any story, but we have a very special opportunity here because Potter King actually publicly released his conversation with an agency that represents him in China called PoppyTube. Now, I've translated the conversation for you, and the text in white is PoppyTube, and the text in green is Potter's company. Now, take a look. When one of the representatives from the agency saw the video, they said, "Potter, Taiwan president, can you delete the video? Do you think this is okay because the video is not on Weibo?" Weibo being the huge Chinese social media website. He says, "Are you endorsing Taiwanese independence? Get back to us once you see this." Now, Potter, being a very snarky person, said, "If Xi Jinping wants to do a video with me, I'd do that too." The agency gets back to him and says, "Potter, the problem is with Taiwan president." They keep going and they say, "You need to delete this immediately. This is very serious. This video, we're going to have to terminate our contract." Now, Potter's partner, Mars, actually chimes in and he says, "Go ahead, terminate the contract." And they say, please delete it. He goes on to say, "I will ask you one more time. Will you delete it?" Asking for confirmation whether or not they will delete the video in question. To which Mars says, "Not a chance. What right do you have to tell us to delete our video? Our head of state visits us and you want us to delete it? Does our contract forbid us from taking pictures with Taiwan's president? Are you really that afraid? Is it really that scary over there in China?"
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay.
So let's review. The big problem here is with, more than anything, calling Tsai a Taiwan president. Now, Potter also says that our Weibo account with over 1 million followers has been seized. We operated it ourselves and now the password has been changed. We cannot log in. Wow. Now, the more interesting thing here is KMT presidential candidate Han Kuo-ryu actually came out in support of Potter King. He actually said that Chinese companies should not penalize Taiwanese individuals in this way and that economic matters and political matters should stay separated.
That's interesting. He's more of a pro-China candidate. Mm-hmm. So it's interesting to see that, you know, him protecting the rights of Taiwanese netizens.
Well, I think it's for his image, because I think most of the people in Taiwan would side with Potter King to have the freedom of speech, right?
Yeah.
And I think it's also very smart of the president to visit a guy like that to get all this attention. Also, he's in Kaohsiung.
You don't really see her in that light, right?
Like,
you don't, and then this guy
just
comes along.
It's casual and fun, and it's really hilarious.
It's a different side of the president than we usually see,
right,
for sure.
And it's a good campaign strategy, good publicity.
Yeah. I wanted to find something Christmas-related, but this is the news of the hour.
Well, thanks, Leslie, and that is Hashtag Taiwan for this week. Leave a comment below. We would love to hear from you.